A new week, a new chapter, and yet again Oda has thrown a curveball at us. In terms of cricket, we call this a googly. So hello and welcome to OdaYZ. My name is Soham and thank you so much for joining in. In this video, we're going to talk about One Piece Chapter 1021. And here we are specifically going to discuss about Momo. But before that, if you're new here, then please consider subscribing to our channel since I do weekly anime and manga related content along with a bunch of other stuff. With that being said, let's begin the video. Now the biggest question for One Piece Chapter 1021, other than the Robin's armament haki or demonio floor moment, is that is Momonosuke actually going to become an adult? This has been a pretty common theory all the way back from Dressrosa, and especially from the moment when Luffy wore him around and we actually got to know the truth behind the Kozuki family and the entire shenanigans that surrounded Odin and the entirety of the Wano country. And it seems like Oda is finally paying off all of these different theories that yes, Momo is now finally going to become an adult as of the final panel of One Piece Chapter 1021, because Momo is asking Shinobu to make him an adult. Now the question is he really going to become an adult? Because this is a very big thing. This is a really, really huge thing, because he has to essentially sacrifice his entire childhood in order to become an adult. But at the same time, his mind is not going to grow. Only his body, his physical body is going to grow, and he's going to lose his entirety of adolescence and his youth at the very same time. But unfortunately, he's not going to mature as a person. He's going to still remain a child inside the body of an adult. So this is a really huge gamble for Momo, and he has a lot of different things at stake at this moment. But for him, the country of Wano Kuni is more important, and that's why he is ready to take this particular challenge. Now, if you ask me, my answer would be here that yes or no, both. Momo might become an adult, but it's really not going to be the way in which most people are thinking it might actually turn out to be. I'm pretty sure that Oda is going to involve something different here. So in order to talk about this, we need to first talk about basically the story of Momotaro. Now I'm not going to go into the details of these things, but it's essentially a very popular folklore, and it has been thought to be a very popular folklore that Oda might eventually use because of the set pieces which he has sort of introduced into the story. So basically, Momotaro is the story of a boy called Momotaro who goes to Onigashima, the demon's island, to defeat the demons, and in his journey he is accompanied by a monkey, a pheasant and a dog, and he basically makes them friend using his kibidango. Now kibidango is obviously a reference to Tama, Momotaro being Momonosuke himself, monkey is obviously Luffy because he is Monkey D. Luffy, dog is Yamato here because of her Inu Ino no Mi fruit, and lastly, now this is a little bit confusing, not exactly confusing, but this is something which a lot of people often talk about, because Marco is technically not a pheasant, he is a phoenix, but it's sort of being utilized interchangeably here. Moreover, some people obviously question that, how is Marco even related to Momo in the very same way how Luffy and Yamato are? So for that, we have to give it a direct or rather an indirect approach, because this is the link for Odin. Odin was one of the commanders of Whitebeard Pirates, so Momo essentially has a very direct connection to Marco, so that is a very obvious thing. But the point here is that Oda very rarely does a one-to-one adaptation of folklores. He often utilizes these folklores, but he definitely gives them a twist of his own. From Shandora being a reference or an allusion to Chandra, which is the Sanskrit word for moon, to a lot of different things, a lot of various different things, mythologies from across the world basically have been used by Oda, but he has often added his own twist to these particular things. Therefore, I don't feel like the Momotaro theory is going to be a one-on-one adaptation where Momo or Momonosuke is the one who is going to defeat Kaido ultimately. I don't think that is the case. Rather, it would be flipped off a little bit where Luffy is the main central character, maybe accompanied by Zoro. That's a topic of discussion for another day. But he's going to be accompanied by Momo, but in a little bit of a different role. He's not going to be a person who's going to fight in the main battle or the final battle against Kaido. He's going to support Luffy, but he's not going to directly face off against Kaido. I don't really feel like the theories of him directly wielding or going back to the village to bring about Ameno Habakiri is actually correct, because if Momo eventually becomes an adult, he's just going to grow into the body of an adult. He's not going to immediately gain all the training. He's not going to immediately definitely become the swordsman that his father was, and he's not going to surpass the level of Zoro. He does not have the mastery over Amino Habakiri at this particular moment in the story. So I don't think that he's definitely going to slash either Kaido or any of the other characters, but he's going to provide a more supportive role towards Luffy, especially in controlling the landmass of Onigashima from crashing down onto the Fire Capital. But even beyond that, let's talk about how Momo might actually become an adult and why I think that there's something much more to this than what Oda is initially trying to portray here in chapter 1021. And in order to understand this, I'm going to introduce two concepts. The first one is from an SBS volume. I'm really sorry, I can't recall the number for it. If I remember it in the post-production, I'm probably going to add it here. Or maybe you can check the comment section below. I might eventually add the number for that SBS volume. But basically, in one particular SBS volume, Oda clarified how the Straw Hats or the other characters are probably going to grow in the future. He had planned two separate routes. He had specifically drawn the caricature for Nami as an old woman, but in two separate paths. The first one is, if the Straw Hats stay true to their dreams, to their aspirations, to their path, then they will grow into very mature people, very handsome looking people. But on the other hand, if they stray away from their path, if they stray away from their dreams, their wills, their aspirations, they will become like a baba, like a ugly old person. That's the basic thing which Oda had sort of hinted to us with these SBS questionnaires. Now, I feel like this is a very major foreshadow for things which are basically happening at this moment in the story, especially considering the character of Shinobu, because she, for the last 20 years, had lost all her ambition. She saw her lord dying in front of her very own eyes, and she saw all the nine scabbards getting scattered across the time frame, and for 20 long years she had been ambitionless. Her dreams had broken down and she was basically drowned into despair. So at this moment, her fruit basically devolved into a separate category. It's sort of like a metaphysical thing. It's not exactly solid proof of body degradation, but rather it's about the will. She basically lost her will to live because of the things that she had to endure, and that's why she had a negative growth in a way, and that might be something which is going to eventually affect her abilities using the Jukujuku no Mi or Jukujuku no Jutsu. And secondly, the other thing which comes into this equation is the Smile Devil Fruit. Now, we have not technically seen what the Jukujuku no Mi or basically any other devil fruit is going to have an effect upon a smile user, because we have to remember here that Momo is a smile user. He is not having any regular devil fruit. So how exactly is it going to influence the overall conditioning of his body? That is something which we don't know yet. There might be a situation, and this is my theory at this moment, I feel like there might be a situation where Shinobu, because of her being old and ambitionless, her fruit is negatively affected in a way, and it might not work in the correct manner which she initially wanted, basically transforming Momo into an adult. But at the same time, because this is a smile fruit, it might affect his overall physiology, his overall biology, and only the aspect of the smile might become an adult or might mature. What I'm trying to say here is that Momo might eventually become a dragon, or rather a mature adult form of a dragon, but this phenomenon, this change, is only going to be limited to his dragon form, the form which is linked directly to his smile devil fruit. Maybe he also has a hybrid form which is going to be affected, but his regular human form, where he's not using his devil fruit, will remain the same. This is sort of, you could say, the side effect of the Smile Devil Fruit, or the side effect of Shinobu losing her will, which is going to negatively or adversely affect her powers in a way which she had not probably projected, or in a way in which she had probably not even thought about. That might be the switch and bait thing which Oda might eventually use here. In that way, Momo remains a kid. He's not eventually becoming an overpowered entity, but at the same time, he will rise to the occasion because he's ready to sacrifice it all, and he's the correct candidate to become the next shogun. So that would be a very poetic justice, very poetic journey for the character of Momo, especially from what we have seen since the days of Punk Hazard. Also, I am very, very excited to see Momo finally taking on Luffy to the top of Onigashima to once again battle Kaido for the final round. How it eventually ends, will Zoro get into the conflict? Those are different topics. Those are topics of discussion for another day. I'm not going to enter that debate here right now. But for me personally, my theory right now is that There's something more to this equation. Momo will not directly just become an adult. That's my theory for you all today. He is eventually going to become an adult, but not in the truest of sense. It's only going to be limited to his mild devil fruit aspects. Again, Oda will probably explain all of these things in a little bit better manner, but the gist of all of these things are here. Moreover, the one thing which everyone is freaking out about is obviously the cover for One Piece chapter 310. Yeah, this is absolutely epic. Oda foreshadowed all of these things. What a man he is. What a mad lad. What a absolute legend. So anyway, these are all the things which I wanted to talk about in relation to One Piece chapter 1021. What do you guys think about all of these things? Please do let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. Do you think Momo is going to become a full-fledged adult with the mind of a child? That just doesn't seem right with me, but who knows, this is One Piece. Our prognostications and theories often go wrong, but even then there are certain theories which eventually turn out to be true, so who knows if this is one of them. So yet again, what do you guys think about all of these things? Please let me know your thoughts in the comment section below, and I'll see you all on the next one. In the meantime, be sure to like, share and subscribe to the channel. Join the channel membership, join our Discord servers for more discussion, links are in the description below. I'll see you all on the next one. This is WonderYZ.